Everyone is going bananas over Google Gemini's new AI image generation tool, NanoBanana. You can find this in your Google Gemini app and it's free. It is incredible in maintaining how you look, even if you change your clothes, even if you change the scenery, even if you add objects. We will go through all of these examples. I want to first show you the official announcement. Earlier today, we launched a state-of-the-art image generation and editing model available in the Gemini app, AI Studio, and Vertex AI. This update introduces advancements in character consistency, precise conversational editing, and the ability to combine photos into a completely new creation. The number one improvement is consistent character design. You could put yourself in different clothes, in different places, and it will still look like the original person of the image that you uploaded. Creative composition. Blend subjects and styles for multiple concepts into a single unified image. I did an example where I put a picture of myself and I put a picture of the Tesla Cybertruck that was able to put me driving the Cybertruck. Local edits. Make precise edits to specific parts of an image. Design and appearance adaptation. It's really good actually with this style and it's not over the top, as we'll see. And logic and reasoning. Here are some crazy use cases. People are optimizing their thumbnails. Make my face as if it was surprised. Add two hands on the sides of my face. Change also the background to a blue gradient. This is insane and this is not possible prior to this with ChatGPT or Manus because I've tried it. You would look like a completely different person. It would probably change the logos and change the letters in that process. Character consistency across different scenes. So it starts with this, and then it says, make her grip a katana with both hands, blade extended horizontally in front of her face. She still looks like the original image. The background still looks like the original image. Turning images into ads. Create a Nike ad with this image with text copy. That's pretty cool. Change clothes. He uploaded this photo and then he changed his clothes. Place products in your images. It's a woman and a necklace. Make her wear the necklace. We're going to go through all of these examples. So let's get started with our first one, which we're going to start very simple. All we're going to do is prompt NanoBanana to change clothes. To actually get there, you could just go to gemini.google.com/app and you'll see 2.5 flash right here. Down here, instead of video, you would do images. Instead of that, though, I like to use it in the AI Studio. So the AI Studio is just aistudio.google.com. It looks something like this. I click X and then down here it says Gemini native image. What's new? Gemini 2.5 flash image generation, which is being marketed as and called NanoBanana. I'm going to click this. You can start with just an idea, but what I'm going to do, because I speak more to business owners, is I'm going to have it change a photo of me that I already have. I'm going to delete this prompt here, click the plus sign, and then I'm going to click upload file. Let's start simple with saying, change the shirt to red, and then you just run the prompt. It's also pretty fast. I'm still pretty much looking the same. I see that one button is unbuttoned, but this is amazing because for, let's say, YouTube thumbnails, you can beta test three against each other. I could do red, I could do blue, I could do green, and I could also change the clothes. I use Google Gemini Studio, so AIstudio.google. Let's try one more color and then I'll change the clothes. Change the shirt to gold. Amazing. I like that one actually. I may get a gold shirt. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the actual clothing. Change the shirt to a fitted black Prada blazer. I could also give it another image, but we'll just start a new chat when it comes to what they call blending. It does look fitted. I see the little attempt to have a Prada logo. This brings us to, you could actually remove objects from the image instantly. I could say remove Prada logo from the blazer. Remove the flowers in the background. It got rid of the flowers in the background. It got rid of the logo. This is very conversational, and you could build on whatever image. And at any given time, you could also download. So let's change the background color, and then let's change the actual scenery in the background. Change the background to bright red with a slight gradient. That is great. Change the scenery in the background to a Harry Potter style. Not too shabby. I love that it understands centering. It put one bookshelf on the left. You could kind of see the depth of how many rows there are. So it doesn't look like a flat background right behind me. It's actually trying in terms of depth, lighting, style, and centering, which I think is pretty cool. Now, what we could do is see how it does when it comes to flight editing styles. I could say, add a bit of depth, drama, and color vibrance to edit this like a pro YouTuber for a thumbnail. Isn't that pretty crazy? In 1 second. I could also delete this response, by the way. Let's say I didn't like it. I could delete. And I could even delete this one. And then I could say, edit this image in the style of Mr. Beast. So if you don't like the output, you could actually have it rerun it, or you can delete it from the chat and it will just go back. I could even tell it what words to put on the thumbnail. Edit this image in the style of a pro YouTuber. Do not add words. This is not bad at all. I could also say change the style of the image. Make this look like a sketch on a journal. You could change it to a sketch. Let's create something from scratch. A Maine Coon cat wearing cold round glasses sitting by a fireplace. Not bad. And you see the glasses, right? We could ask it to give us more of a close-up. Give me a version of the image that is close-up. Here you go. Right? So it went from this. That is a Maine Coon cat, gold glasses, to the close-up being this. I could say, give me an aerial perspective of this image, which is from above. Isn't that wild? And the cat is even looking up. For this to happen in 5 seconds, each one, or 7 seconds, for it to keep the consistency that the cat is pretty much looking the same each image, the environment pretty much looks the same, the lighting looks the same. I mean, I don't know if you would agree with me, but it's pretty impressive. Put impressive in the chat if you definitely would. Understanding how to prompt and what you're trying to get from it is critical to doing this correctly. One of the first pieces of advice that I can give you is just thinking of a practical way to use it. Like for me, the lowest hanging fruit practical way would just be changing the colors of the shirt or clothes, a little bit on the facial expression, just so I could do 3 versions of testing against each other for a YouTube thumbnail. That's just one example. Let's say that you did want to promote a product or do ads for a product or something. There's something called blending. So again, all you would have to do is do Gemini native image and then get rid of this, but you're going to add the 2 images here. So upload file, that's the product. And that's from a previous client of mine. That's his company. So I chose a picture where I'm like kind of pointing like this, and I'm going to say, create an image of the woman on the right holding up the bag of product on the left. If you are in products, you could create so many, like, that's insane. This is insane. So I just put the picture of a bag. I put a picture of myself going like this. You could probably just take it against the wall if you have products. And then look. And the hands look real. So one of the things with AI stuff is, do the hands look real? Do you have the number of fingers that you're supposed to have? Or do they look like nubs or whatever? And that does look real, which is wild. if I were the CEO of a product company, like you could test ads against each other so quickly now, or even if you own a clothing company, it's actually pretty insane. Let's do one where maybe I'm holding up a book, upload file. Let's do Alex Ramosi's Money Models book that just came out. I just got mine in the mail, looking forward to opening it. I make the woman on the left hold up the book on the right. That's in 5 seconds. One of the things that I notice is like, are these still spelled correctly? The ratio is a little off. It looks like the book is a little small for my hand. He has like really big books. So I could just click rerun. So if you don't like the output, you could just click rerun right here. Or I could prompt it down here to say, make the book a little bit bigger. That's much better. I could even do it from there too. And I could say, make the woman have dark brown hair. So you could change your hair. The sky is the limit here. What's cool is, again, it kind of maintained what the face looks like. It made the book a little bit smaller, but you could prompt it to kind of go back to the bigger size. I'll show you what I did with the Tesla one. Create an image of the woman driving the Cybertruck with the windows down. This is hilarious. Now, obviously, that's a little hard, right? But it's not so bad. It put me at least in the driver's seat with the windows down, and the ratios are correct. Again, create an image of this woman driving the Cybertruck on a winding mountain highway at sunset. Not so bad, right? Like, this is terrible, but the actual background and the scenery is not that bad. You could also add things, add podcast headphones and a microphone to the image. It understood the assignment. What it doesn't understand is that the microphone needs a boom arm. Move the microphone a little bit to the side and add a boom arm. For it to understand even where to put the headphones, how the hair would change, and still keep me looking the same is pretty incredible. You see, now it has the boom arm, and I could even say, add AI podcast sign in the background. Isn't that cool? Make this sign much bigger. Let's say I don't understand how to prompt it. It's not giving me the output that I want. I could go to ChatGPT and say, I have a picture of myself with podcast headphones on. I want an AI tool to add AI podcasts in the background as if it were a 3D sign on the wall behind me. Give me the prompt. Then I would copy, go back here. So I'm going to delete this. I'm going to delete this. Delete this, and then I can go here and put in this and run. You see that it understood more. It's putting it behind me as a 3D sign. It's always good to ask an AI tool how you would give it the prompt, because again, the more specific the instructions, the more it could listen. If it's not giving you what you want, we are probably the bottleneck.